Church Conference 2013 is a baby that the Lord gave to me. Well, I was praying one night and the Lord told me there are many shepherds in this nation, but they're not taking care of their sheep in the right way. The Lord started to speak to me from Ezekiel chapter 34. It started to break my heart and I started to ask the Lord why. The Lord said, it is about time that you bring shepherds together and start to import the vision the Father God has for this nation. And that's why we name this conference with this beautiful thing called Real Church, Real People, Real Simple, which is our church motto too. Because the churches are putting up that beautiful plastic smile every Sunday morning, and pastors dressed up in their nicest suit ever, the worship team singing the best song that leads you into the perfect worship mode where you think God is there. But the Lord kept on telling me, and I am not pleased with the way that things are being done. And I asked, what am I going to do, Lord? Because I feel like my church is just the same way. We do good worship, we do good sermon, we have fellowship, what else? He says, you got to follow me because I am the good shepherd and I am entrusting you, my sheep, into your hands. And I said, Lord, I don't know how and when to do it, but would you tell me how and when to do it? And the Lord spoke to us very clearly and gave us a particular date, and the Lord brought the right resource persons. Do this conference. We truly believe through this conference at least 43 pastors' lives have touched. They've been challenged, their vision has been renewed, they've gone home with a new commitment to serve God. The idea of doing this conference is just not to attract people who are about 40 years but below 40 years, basically because to reach out to the youngest nation in the world. And India is one of the youngest nations in the world. We do want the church to be without walls. That was the agenda of the conference. We wanted the pastors to be transparent. We wanted the pastors to be a man of their word. We want the pastors to be real so that people can actually see through him. We taught them about discipleship. We taught them about kingdom building. We taught them about real church, which is organic, not an organizational structure. We taught them about don't be market driven, but be master driven. And I truly believe you heard testimonies, people cried. I've been doing things on my own because I had the strength and talent, but I never sat to listen from God if that was His will. Lord of convictions, Lord of repentance. And lo and behold, there was enough witnesses that the Spirit of God was in our midst. The Lord moved so mightily. There was prophetic gifts. The people speaking in tongues. There were people receiving healing from hurts that has been lying in their hearts for at least 15 to 20 years. Thank you, church, for making this happen. You guys are a blessing. Till Capstone Church Conference 2014. Bye-bye.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry the hopeless, confused and torn, and hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to. Raise our candles and light up the sky.